Welcome to the Spy Collection. I'm Anastasios, and in this episode the item we will look at is less important than the theory behind it. It's a 10-disc replica of a 17th century cylinder cipher system known as Bazeries cylinder from its inventor Commandant Étienne Bazeries, but also known as the Jefferson disc since Thomas Jefferson independently invented the same cipher system. The replica that I have here is also briefly described at the Crypto Museum as being sold online around 2009 to 2010. Although not a realistic device for secure communications, it's an excellent tool to demonstrate this cipher. As you can see, the cylinder consists of 10 disks that are attached to each other. Each disk has a full 26-letter English alphabet. Assuming two parties want to communicate securely using this system, the first thing would be to ensure that both have a cylinder which has the same disks, meaning each alphabet, in the same order. The order of the disk's placement is what we can consider as the encryption key. And since we use the same key for the encryption and decryption, what we have here is symmetric cryptography. For a 10-disc cylinder like this one, the potential combination is what is known as 10 factorial. For those that do not recall what factorial is, let's bring in the notepad. Factorial is denoted by an exclamation mark. So, like this. What this means is that we have 1 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 until we get to 10. In this case, that we have 10 disks, the result of 10 factorial is 3,628,800. And this describes the potential combinations of disk order that we can have in this system. So this is the amount of potential combinations that we can have in this cipher system. More precisely, those are the potential cryptographic keys that we can have. And remember, this is a demonstration for a 10-disc device. Real-world devices would typically have 26 or even more disks. If you check this disk, in order to help us, they also have these two guiding lines, so we can align different words that we want to encrypt. So if we want to encrypt the words spy collect, we would arrange the disk so that the clear text is visible and then just substitute the results. So let's go ahead and do this example. And now we just have to do the substitution. The same letters, such as L in the collect word, in this case resulted in a ciphertext that uses different letters each time. Specifically, in the first L we have the encipherment as I, and the second one was enciphered as C. When a substitution cryptography algorithm has different substitutions for the same letter, it's what it is called polyalphabetic cipher. And this comes from the Greek words poly, which means many, and alphabet. So to summarize, this is a symmetric cryptography system that results in a polyalphabetic ciphertext. Back to the secure communications process now. What would happen next is, after we have enciphered the message we want to transmit, we will send it, and on the receiving end, they will follow the same approach to do the deciphering. So in this case, they will simply align the disks in the same order, And as you can see here, on the top of that we have spy collect. They will just do the same substitution. This cipher system was widely used until the early days of World War II. I don't have to explain that for today's world, this cryptographic method can be easily deciphered. However, if you are interested, I can do a deep dive on the cryptanalysis process. That is, how it can be deciphered without having the key. Let me know in the comments below. Once again, thank you for watching the Spy Collection, and until next time, remember, nothing is as it seems.